Okay, students, good news, our cake survived the freezer. So now what we're going to do is we're going to finish it. I do have my whipped cream whips. And in class, I believe I asked you to make sure that we're going to use our confectioner's sugar. And I like to use the confectioner's sugar. We're going to go with six. Generally, most chefs are going to come in with between 4 to 6 ounces of sugar per quart of cream. Some chefs will use granular, extra fine granular. I actually like to use a confectioner's sugar. And the reason is that I feel it gives a little bit more body to the cream, especially for students who are learning to ice cakes. They need that cake to withstand a little bit longer working time. Now, this is going to be interesting because this is your first cake that you are icing with whipped cream. We also want to note that it's extremely warm in the kitchen today, so we have to be very quick. Some of the rules that we talked about for whipped cream, make sure that our cream is on ice. My cream is not on ice because I'm hopefully working so fast that I'm going to say I don't need it. Now, I pick up the cake in my hand because for me, it's a lot easier to ice with. And I do feel that sometimes the students like this a little bit better. Because what it forces you to do is to have to, in essence, pack that cream, whether it's whipped cream or buttercream, onto the cardboard, and you're trying to fill in the space on the cardboard where the cake stops and you still have space in there. So you can see here that this whipped cream is all the way out to the edge of the cardboard, and I think that's pretty apparent there. Now, you don't have to memorize all the steps that I'm doing. Remember, my cake, for the sake of the video, had no time to chill. Could be a small problem. Also, you always have the opportunity to put a crumb coat on this cake, which would mean we would flat ice it. It would go back in the freezer for about 15 or 20 minutes, and then we would pull it out and put on our final coating of the whipped cream. That's something that we do, and sometimes I hear some of the students call that a dirty ice, but technically what we're saying is that is a crumb coat. So now I have my large cone, there's my water. I want to make sure that we wipe off excess water. And I want to comb the cake. Now the thing about the comb is, it's all in the angle of how you hold that comb. Okay, I see one edge. So even as many years as I've been doing this, you're always going to get one edge. And so what I want to do is I want to go back and look at that. Now, when you get an inferior comb, what it suggests is a couple of things. The angle of your comb is not correct, or you have not put an even amount of your icing on there. So I'm gonna rinse this, reheat it again. Remember, the purpose of the water here, it's not really the water we're looking for, it's more of the heat. So you can see I have that nice angle. I'm gonna go around. Hopefully this should finish it off. Okay, and that does. I have my whipped cream. Now I want to take my spatula, make sure it's dry, and I want to finish off the top of that cake. Now you'll note that when I do my cake icing, I'm working always in the same quadrant, if you will, and that's, I use a lot of clock measurements, so that's the 12 to 3, 12 to 3. So one of the challenges you're going to have today, now if you just saw what I did, I go one way and then I turn that and I'm going back the other way. Hopefully you caught that. That makes a huge difference when you have some buttercream that has a lot of air in it also. Okay, I'm going to say that's finished. Okay, now Now what I want to do is pick this up off the bottom. Remember, we're not going to be putting anything on ours, so I can see that nice flat edge that you're going to have. Make sure you'll note here how clean I try to be. Then I put my doily down. Pink goes right in the center. Now what I want to do is I want to mark it in 12. So I cut it in half, and in half again, so I have four quadrants, and now I must get three out of that. I'm going to be really careful with this because now you're marking your portions, and that looks pretty good. Now what I want to do is put my rosettes. You can see how fast I have to work here. You'll have a little bit more time because your cape will be chilled, and then that should buy a little time in terms of getting the product that you're looking for. Now before I put on the final touches here, I have taken my strawberry and all I do is, obviously this is washed, I cut the strawberry, you would do this with a paring knife, and I cut it again in quarters and I want that cut again. So our strawberry is very, very thin for garnish. And then what you can do is lie these down on a chemise rack, and we're going to cover them with some apricot glaze. Now to this apricot glaze, I've added a little bit of a strawberry puree just to give it a little bit more flavor. So you would have those done while your cake is in the refrigerator. So I will show you just, we'll put the rosettes on each one, and I'll just garnish the one slice so we can march on. My rosette is about a quarter of an inch from the edge of the cake. Now this is, it's nothing major in terms of any kind of fancy decorating. We're going to start very simply. The main goal today is to make sure the cake is as flat as possible and we have good amount of even ingredients. So that would be finished. And then what I would do is we put our strawberry off on an angle. And I will go back and finish that once you all get into production. So that will be our strawberry shortcake. You want to make sure again that the whipped cream doesn't come too close to the edge. We have no crumb coating or coating on the bottom, any border or any type of crumbs, because I want to see how nice and straight you get it. Okay, how to finish a strawberry shortcake. Good luck!